Okay guys, today we're talking about Nizoral for fungal acne and oily scalp. How it works, how to use it properly, and a little science behind it. Plus, we're gonna go over the question I always get. Can ketoconazole lower your testosterone? Let's dive in. Let's get straight into it, guys. All I ask from you is just to hit the like button down below. It tells YouTube this is worth showing to more people. So if you like learning about health from a scientific perspective in a calm and collected way, consider subscribing too. First off, fungal acne isn't actually acne in the classic sense. It's caused by an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast on the skin. This yeast loves oily environments, so if you have a very oily scalp, it's going to be a lovely playground for it. And when it overgrows, you get those small uniform bumps usually on your chest, back, or hairline. The classic fungal acne look. And enter Nizoral, which contains ketoconazole. Why that's effective is because ketoconazole is an antifungal. It stops Malassezia from overgrowing and thriving. That's why Nizoral can be super effective for fungal acne and oily scalps, especially if regular cleansers or acne products aren't cutting it. And for a lot of people, they really aren't. Here's how it works. Ketoconazole targets the fungal cell membrane, specifically a component called ergosterol, which fungi need to survive. Without it, the yeast can't grow, so your bumps start to calm down and your scalp or skin feels less greasy. Plus, ketoconazole has some anti-inflammatory properties too, so it can really help calm redness and irritation associated with fungal overgrowth. So how do you actually use Nizoral for this? For fungal acne on the chest or back, you could use a 2% shampoo or cream, apply it like a cleanser, leave it on for 3 to 5 minutes, then rinse it off. For oily scalps, use it 2 to 3 times per week, massage it in, leave it for a few minutes, rinse it off, and then go back to your regular shampoo routine. Important, don't overdo it. Using it every day can dry out your skin and hair. And always patch test first. Some people do get an irritation with this stuff. Now here's the part people get worried about, ketoconazole and testosterone. High doses of ketoconazole taken orally for fungal infections can suppress testosterone in men. But here's the key. Topical Nizoral, the shampoo or cream, doesn't significantly affect testosterone. Why that is? Because the amount absorbed through the skin is tiny compared to oral doses used in medical settings. So unless you're eating the shampoo, which I hope you aren't, or taking prescription ketoconazole tablets long-term, you don't need to worry about it lowering your testosterone. This is a common myth, but science shows topical use is safe for your hormone levels, just FYI. Before we wrap up, let's quickly talk about tinea versicolor, another common fungal skin issue that is caused by the same Malassezia yeast, but instead of bumps, it usually shows up as discolored patches on the chest, back, or shoulders. Sometimes it's lighter, sometimes it's darker than your normal skin tone. I actually get these flare-ups sometimes, and I'll make a video later on how to get rid of this, like within 3 days, since I found a routine that actually works for me, which if you want to see that video, let me know in the comments below. The great thing is, guys, Nizoral will work for tinea versicolor. The ketoconazole destroys the yeast, stopping it from producing those color-changing compounds that make the patches visible. For tinea versicolor, you typically smear it on the affected area like a body wash, leave it on for 5 to 10 minutes, rinse, and repeat that 2 to 3 times a week for a couple of weeks. Many people see the yeast cleared within a few weeks, but the skin color may take a little longer to normalize because your skin cells need time to refresh. So if you've got these stubborn discolorations, Nizoral isn't just for acne. It's a proven tool for getting rid of tinea versicolor too. I'm gonna leave you guys with pro tips that hopefully you'll remember. Use Nizoral consistently for at least 2 to 4 weeks to see results on fungal acne. Combine it with light, non-oily moisturizers if your skin dries out from it. Avoid heavy oils that feed the Malassezia yeast, things like coconut oil, olive oil, or heavy creams while treating fungal acne. And if your fungal acne or scalp issues don't improve after months, see a dermatologist. Sometimes prescription strength antifungals or other treatments are needed. If you found this helpful, hit that like button below, subscribe for more science-backed skincare and health tips, and drop a comment if you've tried Nizoral and what results you've seen with it. I love hearing your experiences. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys on the next one.